It's time!
All right, coming up next, it's a UFC heavyweight showdown. Well, you can argue this is the most influential martial artist of all time, the great Bruce Lee, making his walk to the octagon here tonight, champ.
Everybody wants to be Bruce Lee. They say they want to be like Mike. If you're a fighter, you want it to be like Bruce Lee. You want it to be that fast. You want it to be that charismatic. You want it to have an ability to just freeze your opponents. Your speed, your movement, just the diversity in the attacks that you can give your opponents would just confuse people. I mean, I watched him beat a 7-foot Kareem Abdul-Jabbar to stay undefeated.
Right.
If you could do that, you could do anything.
I fear not the man who has practiced 10,000 kicks once, but I fear the man who has practiced one kick 10,000 times. Bruce Lee in a nutshell.
Just so wise.
All right, well, he's one of the more accomplished strikers in this division. Sprawl and brawl, whatever you want to say, he's going to try to keep this fight standing tonight.
It does not matter how he accomplishes it. All he wants to do is be on his feet and at range, hitting you with the beautiful jab, staying away from the grappling exchanges. You don't accomplish all the things that this man has accomplished over the course of his career without understanding distance. He has great distance management, which then in turn allows him to land all these beautiful, diverse kicks, spinning back kick, jumping high kick, so many things he possesses that he will try to use tonight in this fight.
Yeah, if this turns into a kickboxing match tonight, most people believe, yeah, his opponent is in a world of trouble. Or tail of the tape for this, our main event of the evening. More than a decade separates these two fighters when it comes to the age, with big differences in height, but some differences in reach. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Eve Loving. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Madison Square Garden Arena in New York City, it's time! 5 rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5'7" tall, weighing in at 145 pounds. Fighting out of Los Angeles, California, USA, Bruce the Dragon Lee. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a boxer making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 6'2" tall, weighing in at 265 pounds. Fighting out of Orange County, California, the Great
Okay, guys, protect yourself at all time, obey my command at all time. If you want to touch love, do it now, go back to your corner.
Start of this fight. I'm anxious, man. What a matchup it is, and it's going to be interesting. And it's going to be interesting to see who has the upper hand early.
It's going to be difficult to find out how this plays out, right? Striker versus well-rounded fighter. Who's going to be the one that's going to control where this fight takes place?
Just missed with that right hand.
Feet into the punch. Feet first.
Oh, huge block. Now he's got the Muay Thai block.
Big punch lands through the middle.
Back to the jab now, no good. Oh, now gets an underhook to get a more dominant position. Muay Thai plump. Oh, huge head kick. Both of these guys going all out. High action.
submission fight here.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman.
So 1 minute into this fight, and as many people expected, the action absolutely crazy, back and forth. This is a full-on brawl, DC.
It's hard to watch a fight like this and call a fight like this because you never know when somebody's going to take that one shot that finishes the fight. Big kick land.
Right hook to the head, blocked.
Ooh, head kick lands, and he's hurt.
And just inches away from landing one of those big right hands.
Look at him chopping the wood with those leg kicks.
All right, single collar tie now.
Sound defensively blocks the shot.
All right, under 3 minutes now to go in round one. Oh, that's a beautiful kick right there. I don't know if you've ever been kicked by a mule. Probably feels something like that.
It has to. This guy has landed this kick with so much force. Look at the force behind that leg kick.
Ball left hook to the head.
Oh! Great punch.
He is all about that left kick to the body. We talked about his reach advantage. Oh, nice job to defend the takedown and scramble to his feet.
If you take more of these leg kicks, you will not be able to be very active on your feet.
Oh, nice jab by him there. And I guess on the other side, hard to get your offense going when your head keeps getting snapped back like a Pez dispenser.
Every time he tries to go forward and use his own offense, the jab is stopping him in his tracks. He's doing a great job of fighting behind him. He's got to be careful dipping his head when he's throwing that jab.
Oh, massive head kick there. We'll see if he can finish.
Lee gets tagged with a kick now. Let's see if he can rally. And they separate.
Look at how he turned his hip into that leg kick. Nice job of hiding that head kick.
Nice defense there. Huge block.
Good punch. Nice sneaky head kick.
And he landed the right hand there.
Loaded up on that right hand, too.
Splits the guard, lands the right hand.
Oh, man, this guy kicks like a mule.
So hard. He kicks so hard every time you see him drive his chest into his opponent.
Everything's landing. Oh, and that kick is blocked. Looked like he might have landed there. Instead, a swing and a miss by Lee.
Head kick.
Oh, collar tie. Unable to connect it. Lands the right hand. Again, they will clinch. All right, let's take a look back at some of the replays, DC, and if you like the kicking game, that was the round for you.
Yeah, man, he used his kicks beautifully. He managed distance, managed space, and eventually those kicks started to really take an effect on his opponent and slow him down. He has to stay the course next round.
Take a seat, bud. Deep breath. Breathe. Into that nose, out through that mouth. All right, here's some water. Listen. Your kicks are working.
All right, next round is underway, DC. We talked about his powerful kicks, how he attacks all sides of the body, the head, the legs. Pretty good start for him tonight.
That was so impressive to see someone fight almost predominantly with their legs and have that level of success. got him whip his hip into that kick.
Oh, single collar tie here. Big left hook coming. It's blocked. Man, the body work really starting to take its toll here. Obvious redness on that right side.
Nice strike.
Oh, nice knee to the head for him there. Just missed with the left there.
He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks. Right where he wants to be in the clinch.
All right, so he's landed some good shots. You hate to be overly critical, but nothing really in terms of combinations.
Well, the jab has been looking great. How about jab, jab, right hand?
Right.
Because eventually you're gonna have to put something on your opponent that's gonna really make him pause. I believe the jab has been working so well, if he drops a big right hand after it, he may be able to finish his fight. Oh!
Oh, big left.
Take many of those, you better check.
Oh, beautiful jab there. It's one thing to have length, of course, it's another to use it effectively. Beautiful job with that jab. All right, so a nice job there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be, and if you do that, most times you will block the shot that's incoming.
All right, he engages in a single collar tie here. Well, he has really picked up the pace here in round two. Much more aggressive than we saw in round one, and now starting to find himself in the pocket. Single collar tie now.
Way to sneak that elbow around the side of the guard.
And here he is back in familiar territory in the clinch.
He has a commitment to kicking tonight, and it shows.
Well done to catch the kick. We'll see what he can do. How good is that right hand? And they separate. Stuffs the takedown there. How good is his takedown defense? All right, he engages in the single collar tie.
Nice punch lands over the top.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. Back and forth we go. Single collar tie. Really timing his shots nicely. Good tempo, very accurate, finding the range with relative ease.
Yeah, he's doing a great job of really overwhelming his opponent with activity.
A little single collar tie there. And they separate. Got clip with the right hand. Oh, and there's a land with the kick, so certainly a good sign for him there.
When that's working, you know he's in for a good night.
Would you look at the size of that bruise on his torso? Nasty.
There you go, look for the shot.
Just a slip there. Oh! Massive kick to the head. There's the kick, it's blocked. All right, so a nice straight punch there after he caught the leg. He decides to punch out as opposed to going for any takedown. He lands flush with that right hand.
Yeah, he's mixed it all up.
All right, he closes the distance, gets the single collar tie.
Big power punch land. Now he gets back to range.
Oh, bone on bone, shin slash foot, right to the skull. You see why I'm a commentator and not a fighter? You see why?
Yeah, those aren't fun. I'm telling you, man, you get kicked in the head. A lot of times, it's the end of the night.
Got a little experience with that.
Yes, I do. It's horrible. Beautiful leg kick thrown.
All right, so no surprise. Once again, we find ourselves here in this clinch situation. We'll see who can advance.
Who's going to be the person to dictate the pressure? Who's going to control the engagement from this 50-50 position?
10 minutes in the books.
Sit down, bro. Take a deep breath. Okay, listen. You need to get a little bit more accurate with those kicks.
What a round. opponent was for him. A lot of head kicks landed, scrambled eggs on the other side. We'll see if he can recover.
He does a great job of hiding it. He gives you no tell. He doesn't show you when he's coming. That's why those kicks have continued to land, even though he's done it multiple times.
All right, so after he landed a high number of kicks in the previous round, we'll see if he can keep it going here as our next round gets underway.
He should stay the course. He's so educated with his legs and his feet that he's given his opponent a very difficult time trying to anticipate what's coming his way.
Lee's head kick is blocked, so no damage inflicted there.
Oh, clinch position. Watch the knees and the elbows come now. Oh, big punch land.
Again, they clinch. And there comes the separation now.
Right hand punch from the clinch.
Oh, he lands another strike to the body. Really starting to pile up these body shots here in the latter stages of this fight. You didn't see a lot of that in the earlier rounds, making up for lost time here.
You gotta check these low leg kicks.
All right, he'll engage in a single collar tie. Oh, nice job to slip off the center line there. His head movement has been a huge, huge factor defensively in this fight.
You can never be a stationary target, so even if the feet aren't moving, you gotta be ready to slip that head at a moment's notice.
Kick right under that right elbow. Nice job to land the straight punch there. Must be nice to have that kind of reach advantage, DC. I know you can't necessarily relate.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
Oh!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's gotta press him. He's gotta go chase that finish down now.
Trying to stay in this fight! Ooh, looking to go to the leg kick here, just out of range.
Yes, they heard him in the last round. Same exact one. Look at the whip action.
Whoa!
That comes out of the leg kick. Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
Man, he is so sound defensively. Nice job to raise the guard there.
It's the relaxation that allows him to see things coming and block most of the strikes that are coming at him. Liver kick.
Whoa!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Are working on the ground here. His opponent's feet on the hips. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Lee's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling. All right, so he's sort of turtled up here. Not great body language. Perhaps he's trying to bait him in a little bit. Both fighters get up now. All right, single collar tie now. And both guys really throwing with authority. Throws a big right hand, but doesn't find its home.
Let's go. Keep that foot.
Trying to hammer that lead leg.
Big leg kick lands.
Goes back to that left kick once again.
Real nice body kick lands.
Let's get some points. Let's get that takedown going. Let's focus now.
Just out of range with that left hook. Oh, collar tie. Whoa!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh, big combination of ground and pound strikes here, DC. This could be the beginning of the end.
I mean, you gotta be very careful when you take these big ground and pound strikes. You need a controlled posture on the bottom, and if you're the top guy, the guy that's looking to finish, continue to gain posture and rain down big strikes on your opponent.
Well, not sure if he's lighter on his feet or what it is, but these last couple of rounds, he's been far more aggressive, a lot more pressure. Oh, he's really starting to light him up now. 20 seconds left.
Liver kick, if you take those kicks, it's gonna shut your body off.
Oh, knee to the head. And they separate.
Nice head kick.
Able to check that kick as well. Archer, there's the end of the round. The big moment in it, of course, the shot to the liver that buckled his opponent.
He hurt it bad. He went right to the liver. Boom, landed it on the sweet spot and was very surprised that his opponent was able to stand up to him. But he's going down the right path. He needs to continue to throw these strikes to the body.
All right, next round is now underway. DC, any major takeaways after the previous 5 minutes?
That both of these guys are very evenly matched. The matchmakers did a fantastic job when they put these two in the octagon. Even though it wasn't crazy, you got to see high-level mixed martial arts.
Well, just as he did the previous round, continuing to land a high number of strikes here, and he hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down. Scary, scary proposition for the opponent. Oh!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish this fight. That's a big strike right there.
Not there. Lee's lower jaw is extremely swollen now. Oh, single collar tie here. Well, he has stayed busy and he has stayed accurate. Nice combination there.
Very accurate, a lot of activity, and the hands look phenomenal tonight.
Beautiful straight counter. All right, he engages in a single collar tie here.
Big kick land. Chase that finish down now.
All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
Working in half guard here, making these shots count. Oh, nice job to reverse position on the ground.
It was bad, but now it's not so bad. What a fantastic sweep.
Back to the feet now.
I mean, he's cutting them down to size.
Oh! And just like that, the fight is over.
Whoa! That was nasty! Oh, my goodness, what a fight.
I'm not sure if that's the way he drew it up, but a huge result for him here tonight as he gets the win by way of knockout. And that's about as good a one-strike finish as we've seen here in the UFC in recent memory. I'm not even sure the opponent saw it coming, so a big, big win for him here tonight. Well, what a moment for him here tonight. A huge knockout on one of the sport's biggest stages. That is one they'll be talking about for some time.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 59 seconds of round number 4. Declaring the winner by knockout, Bruce the Dragon Lee!
And there is the man of the moment, and what a moment this must be like for a professional athlete, right? I know you enjoyed the birth of your kids, right?
Yeah.
But you knock out a man in a cage fight, I can't think of anything better.
I mean, there's nothing like it. You know, you don't even hear the one that lands that puts out your opponent's lights. And tonight, he got that done. And he should be very proud.